This is Soundboy TV, and we're here with Hezron Clark. We're doing an interview with him. He's at the moment actually in Germany, and this is the interview before his first gigs are gonna start off. Hi, Hezron.
I'm good now. Everything good?
Yeah.
Yeah, I'm good vibes. I'm not good vibes.
When did you reach Germany?
Saturday.
Okay.
Saturday, I came from Geneva.
How are you actually coping with this cold here?
We gotta do what we gotta do. You know, I mean, we prepare with all kind of clothing and everything, you know.
But obviously, you're not really wearing a lot right now.
Well, because I'm under the sun.
See? Okay. Yeah. Or you just want to show off when the ladies are gonna watch the video, huh?
No, it's because I'm in the house and I can't see so many things on me. I feel uncomfortable. You know what I mean?
Okay.
Plus, I'm beside you, and so you know what I mean. You
turn and gosh.
Yeah, so, yeah.
Who knows how much heat I can take?
Yeah.
So, guys, I guess this is going to be a sweaty interview. So, anyway, you started off singing R&B.
Yeah, I started singing in church in Jamaica, you know, reggae and dance, and then I moved to the US.
Okay.
And did R&B after a while, you know, and then came back to Jamaica, reggae, you know.
But what was it really, why you changed back to reggae music?
Well, reggae music is a part of me, you know, it's my culture, you know, it's just a journey of every man. You go out into the world and venture, and then naturally, what's inside of you? You know, home is where the heart is, you know, it just pulls you back, you know, so reggae music, after I matured, I just found out that it just naturally started to call me back, you know, and I just, you know what I mean, it was a natural transition.
Okay.
Yeah, and I found, you know, and it was the right time and everything, so.
Okay. Your fans like to get to know you a bit better. Mm. So what is actually your daily routine?
My daily routine is that I get up in the morning and I go to the gym.
Okay.
See, and then I come back and work out, do some musical stuff, you know, warm up and guitars or whatever, you know. And then if I have anything to do in the road, go on the road, I do the errands, then in the night it's studio.
Okay.
Studio session at night.
So just working and being busy and looking after yourself, that your performance is still energetic and you're fit and in shape.
Exactly.
All for the ladies.
Yeah, for the ladies. All for the fans, the people that's listening, people that's paying, but for everybody, especially the ladies. Yeah.
Great, we love that. So who actually did inspire you musically?
There's a lot of inspirational factors we have, you know what I mean? I used to DJ too, so Ninja Man and Shabba and all those guys, Bounty Killer and all those guys were influenced.
Okay.
You know what I mean? And also reggae music, you know, we have Dennis Brown, Bob Marley, Peter Tosh and all those, Madonna, and, you know what I mean? There was a lot of influence with me. And then while in the US, I was into the Casey and the JoJo and those guys, you know.
Ah, okay, Casey and JoJo.
JoJo, yeah, man.
Yeah, we listened to that too when we were young.
Yeah, man. Luther Vandross, you know, my favorite singer and all those guys. Barry Salmon and all. You know what I mean? So it's a lot of influence I have, you know. I think my ear just picked the things that I like, you know.
Okay. Mm-hmm. Cool.
Yeah, man.
So your tunes have a very strong lyrical impact. Mm-hmm. What does actually inspire you?
In life, you know. Life inspired me to write away. It's just that I have the gift of writing also, you know, which, you know, it's just one of them things where I got lucky, you know. So, I mean, everyday living, I put it in a creative way.
Okay.
Because of the writing ability that I have, you know, to creatively put it out and live.
So if you say life, is it more things you experienced or things you see in your friends?
I see and things I experience and see.
Okay.
So, I mean, that's life. So, because whatever my friends experience, what I see.
All right.
Yeah, you know what I mean? And what what I experience is basically things that I see. So, the things I see, you know what I mean? Go through. So.
Okay.
It's just life of so many stories. You understand? And, you know, you come with your DNA and you have to find your unique way of telling the same stories.
All right. Mm. So what do you think when you say just the word unique? What makes you so unique?
I think it's the lyrical thing, you know? the lyrical and the melodic, and probably vocal style that I have. In reggae, I think that made me unique, the vocal style that I have, which is an R&B style. Like, it was influenced by soul and the lyrical content, which I'm a very lyrical guy, and the melody, I'm melodic. So I think that's my unique, and that's what is a unique thing about it. I think people have heard it enough to start believing that's true.
Okay, cool. Yeah. So most of your tunes are about love is rock, and these days it's not always the easiest for love is rock artists. Mm-hmm. And I just want to get your view about it.
Well, I mean, when I just came back from the US, I was singing a lot of love songs because it's a natural thing to come in from the US with a vocal style like mine.
Mm.
Before I went to the US, I was singing a lot of social stuff because living in Jamaica is rough, so you tend to sing that way and DJ that way. Seeing,
mm-hmm.
because a natural thing. You go to the US, it's a happy place. They don't understand the social thing, so they do love songs. So I got influenced. And to be an R&B singer, you sing a lot of love songs and great ideas about love and different concepts about love. When you come and put it, when you come back to Jamaica and reggae rhythm, that's what they're gonna put on it. That's what happened to me.
Okay.
So in the beginning, in the beginning time, the first 3 years of Jamaica, I did some of that, plus one or two social. But after living in Jamaica for 7-8 years, it came back to me. So the first set of songs that I have that people will know will be a love song. And then the latter part that my true fans that follow me started realizing that, you know, there's a lot of social stuff. So it's a balance, I would say, which you will eventually find out when you get, like when you get the album now.
Yeah.
Right when the Dropbox reaches.
Wait, let me just show it.
Mm.
So this is actually the album, guys. You better go and get it.
Lovers Rock to me. And Lovers Rock to me. See, even though they compare me to him a lot, Barry Salmon. He's a, you know, Lovers Rock star and many and some and Gregory, some Lovers Rock to me are like some nice lovers lyrical rock style. my songs, even though they compare to love songs. My love songs to Lovers Rock. When you listen to the lyrical content and everything, you will realize there's a more realistic, reality love song. No?
Okay.
It's just that through the rhythm, it bounces a lot. So, it gives me, according to what people say, and you know, I mean, many people say that, and they say that Ezra Nama more of an international reggae singer.
Okay.
Scene.
Because of the influence from the States.
And the lyrical content and the style of the delivery and the topics that I, you know, mm-hmm. in different ways. So, I mean, I will accept, you know, the Lovers Rock vibes, you know, because it's my culture and everything, you know what I mean? But I just, the people have to know that when you get an S1 album, it will be an equal, equal dishes of every kind of style and every topic, you know what I mean?
Okay.
A lot of social things and all that stuff. So, I mean, you know, and it's delivered just as effective as a love song.
Okay.
Because I'm a reality writer.
So you deliver proper.
Exactly. Yeah, man. So, in the arena, no, Lovers Rock arena, I don't really see where it's because I see Romain Verger, them and those guys, Chris Martin. And I was doing well for, I've been doing well for many years in it. I don't, just that. For many years, people wanted to see me and I never left Jamaica.
Okay.
They know the songs, they hear it all the time, you know, in here and over there, but they don't know who is this guy. But now, I'm able to travel because, you know, circumstances, don't know, you know, we could live and go to all kind of things and we could move through immigration and stuff. But now that I'm free up on everything, the people will see who have been singing these songs.
That's lovely.
Exactly.
A lot of people know your song with Shaggy.
Yeah, exactly.
Two places.
Never seen me yet.
But they never seen your face.
And many other songs. In time, you will know. Because I don't really. Well, you will know. There are many other songs that they. That, like when I perform tomorrow at Silhouettes gave me a list of the songs that people
like to hear.
Yeah, because they know. They say, Ezra, make sure you sing these songs because these are your hit songs here. You know?
Okay.
In Germany, you know, so, and it's a lot, so. But
you even had a song with Silly Walks produced from them.
And that was a hit too, yeah, every time you go away. Yeah.
It was on the rhythm where RC and everybody was on.
Yeah. But I recorded mine
Friday
first.
Friday's rhythm.
Yeah. That mine was recorded long before.
Okay.
I was the first one to go on a rhythm. They came to me in Jamaica a long time. Because when they heard my first song, which was Summer Love, which was a hit song in Jamaica, number one, you know. They came and found me and said, yo. And so, it's like I recorded mine, so it was playing a while, and then about a year and a half later, they decided to do a job, you know.
Okay.
Yeah, man, so. We've been around, you know, we've been working, you know. And if you look, you talk to them and you will find out. And it's just that I'm more about the music, seeing and making sure that when I go back into the world, it's presented properly. Because reggae music is serious music.
So, from all the things you said, it's actually your first time in Europe then?
First time.
Okay. So you said you have the upcoming gig in Hamburg and others?
Yeah, in Geneva. In Switzerland I have one. I can't remember my name. It's online though.
Okay, we have it also on a Soundboids page. So if you want to check it out and of course go to the venue and have a great time. Because he's waiting for you. Ready to entertain you.
Yeah man.
You better go there.
Yeah man. Good vibes man, you know.
How long are you actually going to stay in Europe?
Well, I mean, just for 2 weeks, you know, and most of it gone already.
So it's more like a short trip to get a sniff how Europe
just
is.
Exactly. And to just let them know, because when the album released last year, it resonated here, I heard, you know, and every site I heard that they said it was the best of 2014, and nobody saw me, you know. So I wanted to show them to the sponsor and say, yo, okay, well, I couldn't travel because of certain things, but now I can, and I'm just going to do some minor promotion appearances, like this great interview.
Yes.
Seeing it's not a minor, it's a major step, which will help the album, you know what I mean? It's about the album and the show that City Walks and the other guy, you know, just to, you know, let them know that I can move and I'm here and touch a little thing, and then I go back home and plan for proper stuff, you know.
So 2017 is actually going to be your year.
16, no.
Yeah, you're right. I just wanted to see if you're really listening.
Yeah. That's a good one. Yeah, man. But yeah, I think from 2016 and onwards, you know, it will be a serious thing, you know.
Okay. So you're ready. You're ready to start. You're ready for bookings.
Yeah, man. I'm ready for bookings, man. Yeah. So
guys, you hear this it? You better link him. Yeah, before he's getting too expensive.
Yeah, man. We're here to work and to put the music out there in the world, you know. Because it's long awaited. And you know.
So is there actually something you'd like to tell your fans?
My fans, I'm here, you know. Just get ready. So, you know, but I want to really stress that I appreciate your patience. You know what I mean? I know I'm here, so let's get ready.
So we're looking forward.
Yeah, man.
Looking forward for the gigs.
Yeah,
man. And the good vibes, of course.
Of course. Regular vibes is good vibes.
Always positive. Yeah, thank you very much for your time.
Yeah, man. You too. Man.
We're very happy to have you here.
Mm-hmm.
Enjoy your time.
Yeah, I'm happy for you to come and give me this opportunity to be on your great, you know?
Bless up.
All right. Hey, Soundboy, my name?
Soundboy TV.
Every time, bless up yourself. One love, you know?